When I use start run, why does a window just flash and disappear? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. When I try to use start and then run to run a command, the DOS screen flashes momentarily and then vanishes. Am I overlooking something obvious? Not really. It's only obvious if you've been using PC since before there was Windows and its graphical user interface, or GUI as it's called. Start run is incredibly useful, but it's not appropriate for everything. The good news is there's a very simple trick that fixes exactly what you're seeing. The fundamental problem here, if you want to call it that, is that there are two different types of programs. You're most familiar with programs that sport a graphical user interface, or GUI. Your mail program, your web browser, word processors, and more all display various graphical user interface components, including fancy icons, colorful images and controls, and just about anything that can be drawn on the screen. Before there was a GUI, there was what we now call character mode. A character is a letter, a number, or a special item, including punctuation marks. In character mode, the only things that can be displayed on the screen are characters. Character mode does not support pictures or graphics of any kinds. MS-DOS, the precursor to Windows, used only a character mode user interface. Now, without graphics, the character mode has no icons to click on to run programs. Instead, you type in commands or the name of the program you want to run. You press return and MS-DOS locates the program and runs it. To start the old character mode version of Microsoft Word, for example, you would type Word followed by the Enter key and MS-DOS would run Word. Windows supports both GUI and character mode applications. When you double-click an icon, select a menu item, or use Start Run, Windows looks at the program, determines what kind of program it is, and operates accordingly. For a GUI application, that means, well, run it normally in Windows. For character mode applications, though, Windows first has to start up a character mode environment for that application to run in, and then runs the program in that environment. That environment we call the Windows command prompt. When the character mode program you've run exits, Windows automatically closes the command prompt it started. That window you're seeing flash and disappear is a command prompt window. What happened is this. You typed in your command into the Windows Start Run dialog and clicked OK. Windows located the program, determined it to be a character mode program. Windows started up the Windows command prompt in its own Windows. The program ran within the Windows command prompt. The program finished quickly and exited. And then Windows closed the command prompt window. The flash you're seeing is just the Windows command prompt opening and closing very quickly, as that all happened in a flash. It's really easy to make happen. Let me show you what it looks like. Okay, here we are in Windows 11. I'm going to hold down the Windows key and type R, which gives me the Start Run dialog box. You can see here I already have populated a program called SFC, the System File Checker, and I'll click OK. That was the flash. That was the flash that everybody has been asking about. Let me do it again, this time showing it to you in slow motion so you can kind of sort of see what it is a little bit better. All right. Now, how do we fix this? Well, it's actually pretty simple. There are two ways you can go about this. One is you can right-click on Start, click on Terminal, and then run the Windows command prompt that way. Honestly, a somewhat faster way is to, instead of running SFC, run the command prompt by running CMD. Now we have a Windows command prompt, and we can see what's going on inside of it. If I now type SFC, you can see that it ran and exited really quickly because it couldn't run, right? It couldn't do the job I asked it for. The program simply displayed an error message, and shut down. If this was run via start run, well then yes, of course, we would have opened command prompt, the program would have run, SFC would have displayed its error message, SFC would have exit, and then the command prompt would have closed as well. That's the flash we saw. By running command prompt ourselves and running the command we want to run in the command prompt, we can now actually see what it does. Now, in this specific case, SFC requires that it be run with administrative privileges. The way to do that, of course, is to run command prompt as administrator and then run the command within it. But that's not the point of this video. Now you know how to avoid the flash. The most common cause of a quick flash after typing a command into start run is that the program is a character mode program, or the program has reported an error of some sort and immediately exited. The solution is to run Windows Command Prompt and then type the original command into the resulting Command Prompt window. In fact, if you know you're about to run a character mode program, it's probably best to do that and avoid start run completely. And by the way, when you're done, you've got this command prompt hanging out, just type exit to make it go away, followed by enter. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2729. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.